Hello and welcome to another episode of SoFly Trip Videos. Hey, how's it going, Aldo?
Hey, I'm good, Mitch.
Yoma, how you doing, baby?
I'm fantastic.
And I'm doing good, too. Thank you so much for joining.
Just cut me off, man.
Everybody's good cutting everybody off.
Yeah. No, it's good, boys. It's good to see you. Welcome back from Tomogamy. Of course,
Thank
our
you.
Last trip video was the Bahamas, and I did it solo because... And if you haven't seen it and you're watching this, go watch the Bahamas video, Long Island. But
in fact, here's the link.
Here's the link.
I don't know.
Yeah, maybe we'll make it work. But yeah, welcome back. And yeah, let's get into it. This is a trip that, you know, we did in 2021 to Esnagami Wilderness Resort, Wilderness Lodge. Guys ready to talk about it?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, let's
I'm stoked.
Yeah, let's talk about it because it's a trip that was
this is going well.
Yeah. No, okay, let's jump into it. Esnagami. First of all, the drive up was like 10 hours because that's what the drive is from Toronto. But we stopped in, mm-hmm. if you remember, Tomogamy, because it was before you went to Tomogamy to open the outfitter. So we stopped by there on our way
right.
up, hung out with mm-hmm. Karen and Eric, and you got the
I
little,
was already there.
And you had the little hand. Yeah, you were already there. We met up with you and picked you up and took you with us.
Yeah.
You had the little hands. You were making us a cocktail.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Okay. Does anybody want a drink? I'm gonna get everybody. Bar's open!
It's actually really nice out right now too. It was cold this morning. We had some frost on the old front of the windshield, but it's warming up, so it's gonna be good. You excited, Aldo?
I'm stoked, dude. Yoma.
Does it feel so good to be back here?
Feels so good. Isn't it funny? Like,
also,
last year kind of was the COVID escape, and this year it is still the COVID
still
escape.
Still COVID escape,
it feels
yeah.
definitely more, it feels better this year because it was such a brutal long winter. Last year was like, 3 months into COVID. Now it's been like, over a year.
Yeah, we were thinking it's going to be over soon.
Well, we're vaxxed now. We've been tested.
Yeah.
Everything's good. You know what's cool about this too? We've already been once, so we know what to expect. So it's kind of like going to see some old friends, you know?
Yeah.
Last year was like meeting new people. Now it's like going to see some old buddies.
Yeah.
I'm excited to see everybody.
Man, everybody at Nakina Airport remembered us. You know what I mean?
They're so nice.
It's hard to forget, eh, Yoma?
You guys face are. Like that? Hey!
No, you guys.
Face like that, eh?
No, you guys.
Let me get your tummy.
Do you guys think we should have a fishing competition when we're up there?
Yeah, totally.
And I mean like walleye, because we caught so many walleye last time.
Uh-huh.
We'll each put in, how much money do you guys want to put in for this, by the way?
$5.
Five?
Okay, fine, 20.
I was thinking like 50 bucks, like make it really interesting.
50 bucks?
Yeah. So 20 bucks each, we'll put in 20 bucks. Whoever catches the biggest walleye on this trip wins the pot.
Just watch yourself, take your time, there's no rush.
Give me a hold. What?
Tight squeeze, Avis?
Have a good trip, you guys.
Oh, thanks, thank you so thanks, much. Thanks again for everything.
Ready, here we go, baby.
Here we go, bamboo.
Action.
Yay!
Are you
all right? Hey, how's it going?
How are you?
Good. Nice to see ya.
You too.
Did you know why I love this place?
Yeah, what?
Look at the fucking welcoming party here.
I know, it's awesome.
it's so fun to see everybody again.
But look at them bringing down coffee.
I know. It's awesome.
You gotta be kidding me.
Also, look at the boat.
We got these matching
boats. Oh, you know what that is? Eric just said the fishing at Betty Falls has been the buck wild.
Okay.
On fire at Betty Falls.
Which is insane because it's always,
always amazing. Always amazing. At least from when we were here last time. A year ago, a month from now. So we came at the end of June. It's the end of May. Yep, May 28th. So almost about a month. Month difference. Month earlier this year, so we can really hit the brookies.
We knew exactly what we wanted to do. Because, like, that first day when we landed and got organized, we just went straight to Betty Falls.
Yeah, do you want to go to Betty Falls? And we're all like, yep.
Yeah. Let's just go beeline it across the lake to Betty Falls. And so we did.
Yeah. Yeah, that was super fun. And you know, right away we just got into fish, and it was...
It's always, like, always so fun pike fishing.
Yes. Especially there.
Yeah.
Like, it's deep kind of water, you know, and you just know there's, like, 1,000 fish, and the big fish are maybe a bit deeper, and you just know what to do. You're just like, oh, I'm going to put a full sink on with a big, like, streamer and just catch a 30-inch, 35-inch pike right away. And that's what we did.
Yeah.
Literally immediately.
Fly.
Oh,
there she is.
Oh, nice.
Not a bad pike.
And a beaver. Oh,
nice catch.
Yay!
Yay! Wow, that's a ping in
the street. Yeah.
Yeah. Yes! Oh,
for what thing?
You see that?
Yilma, what was it like going back? Like, were you just as excited, or were you even more excited because you knew what you were getting into?
Even more. I mean, that's, come on. I was even more excited. Yeah, I was excited to, you know, hit that brook trout stretch one more time and give that some more dedication that I didn't do on the first trip. So yeah, the second trip, super excited.
And how did it meet your expectations or exceed?
It did exceed my expectations. It was amazing. It was fantastic. I caught, you know, a few 18-inch brook trout. I felt like, yeah, being guided the same way I was guided the first time, I just felt a little bit more comfortable fishing that river the second time, yeah. Obviously. Mm-hmm.
Yilma, because we didn't shoot on your brookie day, what was it like?
It was similar to, like, the first time, but the first time we went on the first trip, we didn't go all the way down the river. We went kind of halfway. But yeah. This time we did the whole stretch all the way down to where it kind of opens up.
We went far, yeah.
Yeah, we went far, which was really nice. So we got to explore the whole river. The water levels were a little higher, so there wasn't a lot of structure. So it was hard fishing, but Adis and I did work our ass off, and we did catch some really nice, phenomenal, beautiful-looking brook trout. For sure.
It was great. It was a great day.
We had a lot of fun. Got to run down there a good ways.
Do you think Yilma's crazy?
He has his moments.
Ah, nuts.
I remember, you know, last time when we were there, it was like we got there and it was like, okay, you know, we're going to hit the Brook Trout River in a couple days. So we were like mentally like preparing for this like epic journey. But when we got there that day, Eric was like, okay, Mitch, although I'm going to take you down to the Brook Trout tomorrow. Does that work for you? And I was like, I'm not ready like yet. I was too excited, or I remember having to get settled a little bit. And then, but it was wicked because we hit the Brook Trout right away.
And had a really good day.
Yeah, we did.
Well, Mitch, back down the river?
Yep, take two. Back down the Esnagami River. Looks like there's some clouds back there rolling in, but maybe it'll get sunny out today. It's going to be a good day.
You think we'll catch a big Brook Trout, Ides?
Oh, yeah, you guys are going to catch a big Brook Trout for sure.
What kind of fly should I use?
Ooh.
We're using worms today, fellas.
Yep.
Just hooks and worms. Lots of weight. Yeah. Trebs, probably.
Yeah, that sounds all right.
Or the new hook, the four hook one.
Yep.
The quads.
Yep.
Major caddis hatch going on.
Pretty cool. Caddis coming off. Lots of caddis. Lots of black flies.
Yeah, lots of black flies.
Lots of caddis.
We stopped at Baptiste Jacob's like trapper cabin, remember? Like,
yes.
And of course, Baptiste Jacob was like an indigenous man that lived up in that area that Eric was like Eric's mentor, right? He's told us all kinds of stories, but yeah, we looked at that cabin and there was like still Eric's like, I haven't been here in forever, and there was still beaver traps like hanging from the ceiling, remember? It was crazy.
You know, I think in our first video when Eric mentions when he's cooking lunch how he learned from Baptiste Jacob had a clean walleye, you know, and fry them so you don't, you know, in a certain way, whatever.
The key is putting the skin side down so that where the side where you filleted the skin off of, put that in the pan first and your fish won't curl up on you. Little trick I learned from a Ojibwe guide. Baptiste Jacob, a legend in our area here.
It was cool kind of like seeing where this person lived and trapped and you know, just it's cool. So it can't, without being able to put a face to the name, you know, it's kind of, in a way, feeling that energy and seeing where, you know, he learned what he learned and passed it on to Eric, and that was really special.
He used to come down in the winter to fish and guide in the summer at the lodge, and then he'd come down here in the winter and trap beaver. So it'd be like 30, 40 below, and he'd be down running his trap line, and then he'd come back to his staging cabin here and dress the pelts up and hang them. And I saw a pretty cool little picture of him. He's in there, he's sitting on his cot, there's a fire going, there's beaver pelts hanging down, and you can see through the walls like it's snowing outside and that. So true pioneer and you know, trapper, outdoorsman, guide, and a very very unique you know, old school, who made a really good living out of you know, kind of living off the land and taking with it that what the land gave him. So yeah, we shout out to Baptiste all the time. He gave us a lot of knowledge on this area, and he's resting in peace now, but we keep his kind of story alive in that.
Well, Mitch, it's two years in a row, me and you.
Yeah,
and down Eric. And Eric. Eric's like, great, I'm stuck with these guys again.
There's no, it's not an option of being stuck. This is river and being able to run it. Believe me, you guys are doing me a favor today.
Lunch!
Thank you.
Remember when I was like stuck in the tree and or we were stuck in the tree and I was like, or I was holding on so we wouldn't go down river, and you were like making casts in that like crazy pocket kind of water. That was awesome. Yeah. That was so funny.
It was awesome. Like Eric hooked a fish, and I remember one moment, yeah, you were holding on a tree. Eric was trying to land a fish and work the motor. And then I was like on the video camera, like just trying to get the whole thing.
Yeah, that's right.
It was pretty buck. One awesome memory I have is when we were going back upstream and the sun was really hitting the river. And Mitchell, you turn around, you're like, look down. And we look down in the water and the brook trout were following the boat. Like they were beside the boat swimming, you know, like huge 4 or 5 pound 20 inch brookies, you know, either finning in the current or the water's so clear that you can see them. I remember like,
whoa,
that was a really, really cool moment.
This is the first time I'm hearing about this.
Yeah. Well, we didn't get it on film, so sorry. But yeah, I mean, we didn't have our underwater housing at that time. So
it was cool. But they were like 12 feet. They were like 12 feet deep. Like it was way deeper than, you know, you thought. And we could just see them like running up behind rocks, like big, big brookies, like a bunch of them. It was like, Oh my God. It would be such a cool place to scuba dive. Like just to swim in that water, like that tannic water, which is the most wild, you know, Arctic watershed brook trout. Like, geez.
Yeah.
But then after the brickie trips, cause we both, you know, I think we all had a great time on the brickie rivers, but then we spent the next 6 days just fishing pike, walleye, exploring the whole lake with Liam and Eric. And, that was awesome.
Yeah, that was good. Yeah.
Maybe this is the video. Whoa!
Artera,
you're rolling
right now? Yeah, he's rolling right now.
Does it say standby?
Yeah, it says recording. And all the red lights on.
Oh!
Yay!
Look, we're camp counselors. Look at us. We're all the same thing. Camp counselors!
No knives! My name's Idis, this is pike fishing in Esnagami Lake.
Holy sh-
He's down dogging you right now, bud. Is it? Yes.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Nice. Nice fish. Nice fishing. It's Yeti content, eh?
This is the fly I've been using. I don't know what it's called. And it's got the stripies.
Yelma, right here. Yelma, right here. Yelma.
Look.
He's 25 feet back, bruh. Yo, these are all fish. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 9 o'clock, 9 o'clock. Yo, cast, quick.
Nine.
Perfect stop.
10 p.m. 10 p.m.
Death cake, go. Strip. Can I try?
We are fulfilling the contest of walleye champions tonight. Mitch right now has the record of 21 inches, and Aldo and I are going out. And we're going to get 23, 25, maybe even 30, you know, because we can't let Mitch win.
I don't care who wins this. If Mitch wins this, we'll never hear the end of it.
What are you worried about, Yoma?
I'm not worried at all. I'm going to win.
Are you concerned about your title going down tonight?
No, definitely not. We're with Eric. We're going to catch the biggest fish. I'm just getting my title will increase. In fact, maybe we'll be tied. We can split the pot.
I'd be fine. Ooh, I like that. Put it to our little backyard.
So long, yeah, exactly. So long as it's not Yilma and Aldo. Whatever.
As long as your line's in the water, there's a chance. Even if you're like running up the rapids.
Yeah, exactly. You know, we had that last day on where we went back to Betty Falls, just like we started, and just like went nuts on walleye and pike. But then we had the topwater walleye.
Yeah, so
didn't you hold onto a tree also so that you guys can get a little closer up the waterfall?
Yeah. Oh, we tied the boat off to a tree. Oh, right. Yeah.
So we could get really tight into the shallow part of the waterfall and just put on poppers and just catch walleye on top water. And they were just smoking. Kind
of, it was crazy. Like we noticed, you know, Yilma, I think you were in that bay around the corner where you caught the the pike with the jig in its mouth.
Yeah.
And Mitchie and I were in the, and it was like this brilliantly sunny day, and like I remember, Mitch, you were just in a t-shirt and that funny straw hat, like Adis's straw hat.
Yeah.
And I remember, I'm like, wow, it's so hot. And then it happened a couple times where, like, just as your streamer was hitting the water, they would eat it right away. And then so I was like, you know, I bet you a popper would work. And so we took tight on big saltwater poppers, and we were catching walleye on poppers. Yeah. How insane is that?
so cool.
Fish out.
Fish on.
Hey, I'm Mighty Mitch. This is Power Fishing. Hey, welcome to Thunderstruck Fishing. Welcome to Big Rock Bass Assassins, Tower and Timber Fishing. We're up at Esnagami Lodge, Northern Ontario. We're going to be going for a walleye. Stick with us.
Honestly, man, like, Yilma, that was the best trip, eh?
Yeah, honestly, probably, you know, one of my top trips of all time, you know, for the past, 7 years we've been fishing together. And, you know, the staff is incredible.
Has it been that long?
It has. Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Sorry.
Almost eight. Isn't that crazy? But, yeah, we've been done. I mean, Esnagami's 2 years, and it is, like, such a great experience, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. Unbelievable fishing conditions, great, you know, aggressive northern pike fishing, fun walleye fishing. You know when you go to fishing for walleye, southern Ontario, and they kind of just like, you know, and you reel them up.
Yeah.
It's not like that there. They fight like smallmouth.
Feisty.
Yeah, feisty little monkeys. And comfortable cabins, amazing service, amazing food, just friendly people.
So much food.
Yeah, so much food. Get ready to eat because you're not coming back skinny.
No.
And it's back. You know, it's like really far north, you know, so you're like away, you know, so yeah, it's good.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
Yeah, I mean, I think I said this on our first podcast and on this the podcast about this show, about this trip, sorry. You know, from a hospitality standpoint, it's dialed.
Mint.
From the like you said, like from the minute you, even like at Nakina Air, the people at Nakina Air are so great and they're so organized, and you know, like you get there, they help you unload your car, they help you weigh in. Like it's not, you know, they load the plane, but like they're not going to let you load the plane by yourself. Imagine. We that up for
all
sure.
All right. Take off, boys.
But but you're right, Mitch. You know, from the second you land to the second you leave, you feel like really taken care of. And there's like nice little touches, like, you know, the person who's managing the docks for the day doesn't finish their day until the last boat is in. So there's always somebody to welcome you and, and leash your, you know, and dock the boat with you. And you know that when you get back in the boat in the morning, you know, you could leave your rods there because your boat's yours and it's refueled and it's cleaned. I mean, not that we leave our boat like in a shitty mess, but let's say if you did, or if like a windstorm knocked a bunch of branches or leaves in it, you know, that's not how you would find it in the morning. So it's just all those little, it's all those little touches that really, you know, make the trip special. And then there's the fishing, and it's not like it was a passive thing. That the fishing's amazing. Like Eric's put a lot of work into a catch and release program and a trophy program and an incentivized program, which, you know, when he got the lodge back in the 90s, probably was not very easy, but he stuck with it. And look at it now. Like every cast you catch a walleye, every single cast.
Yeah.
Like what? It's such a good fishery. And then every fifth cast you catch a pike. Yeah. And then if you're on the Brookie River, you catch 25 plus brookies with, you know,
don't forget whitefish
being in the
and whitefish too. Yeah,
and then the whitefish. Yeah,
like,
and then
nice fish. Yeah,
nice fish. You know, like so. What an amazing job they've done, and I know they're, you know, Eric's looking at retiring, and so congrats, Eric, because you did an amazing job, and so lucky to have been able to be hosted by you before you hung your hat up, so to speak. So yeah, thanks.
Thanks, Eric. Thanks, Sue. Thanks, Liam. Thanks, Rowan. Thanks to the whole staff at Esnagami Lodge for having us back for another year.
Thanks to Idas for, I mean, he helped a lot with the capture. So a lot of what you're seeing is what he's captured. So, you know, thanks, Idas. And thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, you stupid dumb.
What? We're going to bleep that out, right? Okay, thank you, stupid.